the SST classroom. Now in the last video, we discussed about the natives of India, right? And what we have learned in that? We have learned about the plateaus. What is plateaus? Right? The land which is flat and higher than its surrounding area is known as plateau, right? This we have learned. Later we discuss about the peninsular plateau. And then afterward, I explain you the plateau is divided into two parts, that is the central highland and Deccan plateau. So in the last video, we discussed about the central highland. Okay children, so today we are going to discuss about the Deccan plateau. Now Deccan plateau is also called a great peninsular plateau. Got it my children? Now this Deccan plateau, the Deccan word, it has taken from the Sanskrit word. This has taken from Sanskrit word, which means Dakshina, means that is south. Got it my children? Now we see the location of Deccan plateau. Now it extends from Narmada up to the southern tip of peninsular plateau. As I explain you, the plateau, the river Narmada, it divides the plateau into two parts. So from now this Deccan plateau, it extends from Narmada up to the southern tip of peninsular plateau. Now here you will see Anaimudi is the highest peak in this plateau. Got it my children? And it is surrounded by western Ghat and eastern Ghat. I explain you western and eastern Ghats, right? So these Ghats meet at place that is known as Nilgiri Hills. Got it my children? Now it is surrounded. Now here you will see the river which flow in the Deccan plateau are Godavari, Krishna and Kaveri. This river flow to the eastward and fall into the Bay of Bengal. Got it my children? So the plateau is bounded on the east and west by the Ghats, while its north is the Satpura mountain range. Got it my children? And on the western edge of the plateau lies the Sayadri Hills, Nilgiri, Anaimala and Cardamom Hill, and it is commonly known as Western Ghats. Got it my children? What I talk about the Deccan plateau, that it is bounded on east and west by the Ghats, while in the north it is the Satpura mountain range. Got it my children? And on the western edge of the plateau, there are many hills which lie in the western edge of the plateau, that is Sayadri, Anaimalai, Cardamom Hill, and this all is commonly known as the Western Ghats. And on the eastern part, it is also Eastern Deccan Plateau, it is also known as Telangana. Got it my children? And Deccan Plateau, here the dam is also built on this plateau. As I talk, there are many rivers in the Deccan Plateau, that is the river Godavari, Krishna, Kaveri, right? And Godavari is the longest river in the Deccan Plateau. We talk about the longest river in India, that is the Ganga, which is in the north. But here in the Deccan Plateau, in the south, Godavari is the longest river. And this river is also the scared river. Means people, as on the Ganga, it is a holy place. So same as Godavari is also the holy place for Hindus. Got it, my children? And here, as I talk, the dam is built on many river. Example, Nagarjuna Sagar Dam is built on the river Krishna. And the dam is very useful for the purpose of irrigation facility and also for the water. Got it? Now, this second plateau is also rich in mineral. So here, the mineral like coal, iron, gold, mica, etc. are found in the Deccan plateau. Got it, my children? And here, the language here in the Deccan plateau, mostly they speak the Telugu language. Got it, my children? And here, the people are also engaged in agriculture activity. Got it, my children? Understood about the Deccan?